The other day, I saw this video by Jake in Motion where he used ChatGPT to create scripts for After Effects. And then I thought, I wonder if it works for Illustrator. So naturally, I tried it out and the end result was just way better than I could have ever expected. Come with me and I'll show you. First and foremost, ChatGPT is just too long of a name, so we're calling him Chatty from now on. He doesn't seem to mind. I decided I was going to ask Chatty something very simple, because even though Jake had success in his journey, I feel like After Effects scripting is more well documented than Illustrator scripting, so I didn't want to go too hard on GPT. My goal was to make a script that would tell me the selected object's size and area, regardless of the object's shape. It could be a circle, a square, or even a random blob. And bear in mind, I have close to no knowledge on coding, so I would have no idea how to properly approach this. Now, grab some coffee, get a snack, and get ready, because we're about to embark on a really fun coding, Illustrator, artificial intelligence adventure. I started a new conversation with Chatty, and since I'm not a terrible friend, I begin with a little bit of small talk, just to break the ice. Okay, that's enough. Let's get to work. I prompted Chatty the following. In JavaScript, write a code for Adobe Illustrator that calculates the size and area of the selected object. And to my surprise, he hit me with a wall of JavaScript code, and honestly, I felt super excited about it. So I pasted the code on Notepad, saved it as a JSX file in the scripts folder, opened Illustrator and ran the script. And it didn't work. So I told Chatty there was an error on line 28 of the code, and it tried to fix it, but it didn't work again. And again, and again, and again. Then I tried to start new conversations and prompt the same thing, and he gave me a different code every time, but they all failed in some way. Ugh, I thought this would be easier. At this point, I was considering giving up, but then I remembered that in his video, Jake used an approach of building the code bit by bit, asking ChatGPT one simple thing at a time. And when it was needed, he would even go after the official After Effects documentation to try to understand what was going on. Okay, fair. Let's give Chatty one more chance. Before that though, I decided to learn the basics of JavaScript, just so I could roughly understand what was going on. I also used ChatGPT to do it, asking it to explain me the basics of the language. And this Chatty does really well. He's a great study companion. But don't worry, I didn't go too deep into it. I just got a basic understanding of things like variables, data types, operators, and if-else statements, which honestly is something you could learn in less than an hour of studying. I also didn't write any code myself at any point in this video. I just used this knowledge to understand how ChatGPT was structuring the code and possibly help it in fixing some of the errors. Okay, back to creating our script. I decided to start with the most basic thing I could think of, a script that checks if there is an object selected. I prompted Chatty, it gave me this code, and wow, I can actually understand what it's doing with just an hour or so of studying. That's exciting. ChatGPT created two variables, which are like containers where you can store information. One called doc for document, which is accessing the document that we have open, and one called cell for selection, which is accessing the selected objects inside the document. Then it created an if-else statement, which runs specific blocks of code when specific conditions are met or not. So it's basically, if this code is true, do this, else do that. This if-else statement checks if there's one, more than one, or no object selected, and then prompts a different alert for each case. I ran the script in Illustrator and yeah, it's working perfectly. Okay, now I'm really excited. Let's go back to Chatty. Now that I know that I can somewhat understand the structure of the code, I asked Chatty to write something a bit more complex, a script that informs the size of the object. The code started with the same document and selection variables and then calculated the size of the selected object with an if-else statement, checking if there was only one object selected, calculating the width and height of the selection by using the geometric bounds of the object, and then displaying the result. Right off the bat, I noticed it added the word points to the alert message, which doesn't make much sense since the document might be using a different measurement unit. Still, let's test this out in Illustrator. and, well, it's technically working, but wrong unit and way too many decimals. Let's try to fix these issues, but one at a time. I asked Chatty to replace the word points on line 8 of the code for the active measurement unit of the document, guessing that there might be a way to access this information. And apparently, there is. GPT added the unit variable inside the if-else statement, retrieving the measurement unit currently being used on the ruler, and then converting it to text using the toString method. Also, I couldn't help but notice that it also added the toFixed method to the width and height variables, which is a method used to round up numbers and only display the amount of decimals that you place inside the parentheses. It's odd because we needed to do that, but we also didn't ask for it. Anyways, let's run the code in Illustrator and yeah, the amount of decimals shown is now only 2. The thing we didn't ask for works perfectly. The measurement unit, on the other hand, well, to be fair with Chatty, it did kinda work. You can see that the alert is, indeed, retrieving the right measurement unit from the ruler, but it's using code language instead of just a regular word, like pixels. So I kindly asked Chatty to fix it, and he replied back saying that the solution was a switch statement. I don't know anything about those. Let's ask Chatty again. Oh, okay. Switch statements are a way to perform different actions based on different conditions. It feels like an if-else statement on steroids. Okay, looks very promising. It's listing all the possible attributes of ruler units as conditions, and then assigning the corresponding measurement unit to the unit variable when the condition is met. It's also worth mentioning the fun fact that Chatty reminded us that the code is now using the toFixed method to reduce the number of decimals, kinda like it was trying to show us it did something without us even asking, or just pointing the changes out so we understand what's happening, since we didn't say anything about it. Anyways, I run the new version of the script in Illustrator and it worked flawlessly. However, upon further testing, I noticed it was displaying decimals even when the width or height were whole numbers, so I asked Chatty to fix that. And props to him for understanding what I was saying even though I explained in the worst way possible. Chatty added, before the alert, 2 more if-else statements where it checks if the numbers are whole or not, and changed the toFixed methods for each condition. I ran the code in Illustrator and flawless again. Now, let's move on to calculating the area. I kindly asked Chatty to include a second line on the alert where it would inform us the area of the object, but I can already see some problems with the code. Chatty added a new variable called area and simply multiplied the width for the height. It works fine for rectangles, but not for any other shape. I tested it anyways and it seems to be working properly despite the wrong math. I informed him that the code worked, but we faced a limitation with the math, and questioned him about calculating the area of ellipses. Chatty then wrote a new code and added a new if-else statement, where he was trying to access the type name attribute of the selected object and checking if it was a rectangle or an ellipse. For each case, it would run a different code to calculate the correct area. I knew it would still not calculate the area of a random shape that was neither a rectangle or an ellipse, but if the code worked, we would be a step closer anyways. However, it didn't. It was the first error so far on this run, but I thought to myself, well, hopefully it's the only one. Spoiler alert, it wasn't. I informed Chatty about the error and pointed which line it had happened, and apparently it was just a single word that was unnecessary in the code and caused everything to stop working. Wow, that's kinda scary, not gonna lie. I ran the new code and got the same error again. Huh? How so? I checked the latest version of the code and apparently ChatGPT didn't remove the word it said it would. That's odd. That's such an easy request. GPT just sent the same code again. Well, I decided not to bother Chatty about it and just removed the word myself. Then I ran the code again. Okay, new error. The code was now triggering the alert that says the selected object is not a rectangle or ellipse, but that was clearly not the case. My guess is that the whole type name strategy didn't work as intended, so I informed Chatty about it. And apparently I was right. Okay, error fixing, new code, copy, paste, save, Illustrator, run. Ugh. Okay, it was time to get my hands dirty. I decided I was gonna fix this issue myself. I'm ready to spend hours studying, days even. I'm gonna master JavaScript and Illustrator scripting. I'm gonna become the greatest script creator the world has ever seen. And I'm gonna become rich and famous, and the whole world is gonna love me. Oh, apparently there's an area property you can access by typing .area. So you actually don't need to calculate anything. Nice. I kindly suggested Chatty we took a different approach to the area problem, and he was totally on board with it. I pointed the .area attribute to him, and he promptly made the necessary changes. So here we go again. New code, Illustrator, run, and it worked! No errors, no issues, it's perfect! I wasn't expecting it to work all of a sudden like this. And props to Chatty for including all the code that was needed to round up the numbers of the area as well, without us even asking for it. I thank Chatty, to which he was as polite as ever, finished the conversation, and now I had my first Illustrator script created in collaboration with ChatGPT. It was honestly such a fun experience, in which I actually learned a whole bunch of new things. I feel ready to start writing my own scripts, and perhaps I'll even look more into JavaScript in the future. Who knows when it might be useful. If you enjoyed this video, check this other one here. A special thanks to all my Patreon supporters who help me make high quality content like this one. More on how you can support the channel in the description down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you have any doubts. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye!